If you like to talk to tomatoes,
if a squash can make you smile, if you like to waltz with potatoes, up and down the produce aisle,
have we got a show for you.
Hi there, this is Larry the Cucumber. On behalf of Bob the Tomato and all my veggie friends, welcome to this special episode of Veggie Tales, brought to you by Chick-fil-A. We hope you enjoy the story, the silly songs, and especially the very important lesson. So listen closely, and now, get ready for the story of Larry Boy and the Fib from Outer Space.
Time for Veggie Tales!
Hi, kids, and welcome to Veggie Tales. I'm Bob the Tomato.
And I'm Larry the Cucumber, and we're here to answer your questions.
That's right. So, who's got a question?
Oh, hey, I just remembered. I got an email from a kid named Ezio Vieri in Hackensack, New Jersey. Ezio said he just did something that he knew he wasn't supposed to do. Now his friends are telling him to lie about it so he won't get in trouble. What should he do?
Ooh, a lie can be a very dangerous thing. Do we have any stories about that?
Bob, I'm all over it.
Huh?
The same thing happened to Junior Asparagus once.
It did? I don't remember.
Ezio, get ready for Larry Boy and the Fib from Outer Space.
I'm bored, Jerry. B-O-R-D, bored. Why did we want to work at the Bumbleyburg Science Lab? Because we wanted to see space aliens. And what have we seen in 2 long years? Huh? Nothing. Nothing. N-U-T. You know, nothing.
Jimmy?
Watch the screen, they said. Keep your eyes on the screen. So we watched the screen for 2 years. And what do we see? Nothing.
Jimmy?
And then there's the light. If this light ever flashes, something from space is about to hit Bumbleyburg. Alert Larry Boy immediately.
Jimmy.
Like that'll ever happen. I'm telling you, Jerry, this is the most boring job on Earth. Maybe we could get our old jobs back at Mr. Slushy. What?
Tea party is almost ready. We just need one more plate for Mr. Snuggly.
Another plate.
I know just where to get one. Where?
Up there.
That looks like a very special plate. Maybe we could find another one.
Oh, it is a special plate. My dad says,
that's Art Bugatti, the greatest bowler that ever rolled a ball. Only 200 plates made. It's collectible.
Let's just find another plate.
Mr. Snuggly is a very special bear. He deserves a special plate. I'm sure my dad won't mind.
Oh, I just remembered. I was supposed to wash my, I have to take out the, I gotta go.
Psst. Hey, kid, looks like you got a problem.
Huh? Who said that?
If you're interested, I think I can help.
Mr. Snuggly, you can talk?
Well, I've never been called Mr. Snuggly before, but of course I can talk. Actually, the name is Fibrilius Minimus, but you can call me Fib.
You must be new to the neighborhood.
You could say that, but more importantly, I'm here to help you out. I couldn't help but notice you broke the plate.
Yeah,
And I imagine your father's not gonna be thrilled.
Well, yeah.
Now listen closely. What you need is a story.
You mean like a bedtime story?
No. Now try to keep up here, kid. You need to make up a story about how somebody else broke the plate.
You mean you want me to lie?
No, not a lie. What we are talking about here is just a little fib. People do it all the time, trust me. A little fib couldn't hurt anybody.
I'm home.
Well, it's up to you, kid. Break a leg.
Hi, Junior. How was your day today? My plate! My Art Bugatti limited edition collector's plate! What happened to it?
Well, it's Laura's fault. She broke the plate. I tried to stop her. She said she had to demonstrate her apple chopper. The apple chopper worked just great, but chopped her through your bowling plate. It's Laura's fault. She broke the plate. It's true. And that's the tale I have to tell to you.
Oh, my. If that's what you say happened, then, well, I trust you, Junior. But I'm very surprised at Laura. I'm going to have to call her father right away.
You did it! Good work, kid!
Huh? Have you grown?
Oh, no. I've always been this size. But you were magnificent.
I don't know. What about Laura?
Oh, she'll be fine. Remember, a little fib couldn't hurt anybody. And besides, it's over. You're free.
You're right. I don't have to worry about that plate anymore. I'm free.
You betcha.
I feel great. You were right. A little fib can't hurt anybody.
That's my boy. Come on, kid. Let's go have some more fun.
All righty. I'm with you all the way, fib.
Loud and clear, Alfred. Go ahead.
Yes. Have you located the foreign object?
I'm afraid not. The Larrymobile and I have been all over Bumbleyburg, and we haven't seen anything that looks like it came from outer space.
Nothing at all?
Well, we did see a kid with green hair. Oh, and a dog that could whistle.
Oh, all right. Well, keep looking, Master Larry. Remember, the security of Bumbleyburg rests in your... plungers.
Have no fear, Alfred. If there's a space alien in this town, Larry Boy will bring him in. Hey, Junior.
Hi, Percy.
Junior, I just came from Laura's house, and she got in trouble for breaking your dad's bowling plate. Except she says she didn't break it. She says you did. Who's telling the truth?
Oh, well, actually... she's right.
Huh?
Laura didn't break the plate. It was Lenny.
Her brother?
Yep, that's right. Lenny broke the plate. I'll tell you the whole story. It's Lenny's fault he broke the plate. He's very naughty. Just how was I to know he hated Art Bugatti? He gave it to a crocodile who chewed it up for quite a while. It's Lenny's fault he broke the plate. It's true. And that's the tale I have to tell to you.
Whoa. Gee. I didn't think Lenny was capable of that kind of violence. He seemed like such a nice kid. I didn't even know he had a crocodile.
This is great. It worked again, Fib. Fib? You are growing.
Growing? Oh, no. Well, maybe I put on a few pounds, but Junior, I will always be your little fib.
You've got legs.
Yes, I do. But enough about me. Junior, you were marvelous. What a story. I'm telling you, kid, you've got the gift.
Really?
Oh, yeah, no doubt about it. You've got what it takes.
I'm telling you, Alfred, I've looked everywhere. It's just not here.
Master Larry, I've gone all over the data from the science lab, and I have to agree with their conclusions. Something from outer space landed in Bumbleyburg. It simply has to be around there somewhere.
Look, Alfred,
I've been driving around all day. I'm tired. I'm hungry. I've got to go to the bathroom. This suit is very constricting. I'm coming home now.
But the security of Bumblyburg rests in you.
There are no space aliens in Bumblyburg.
There he is! Hi, guys.
If you need me, I'll be over here.
Huh?
No, no, that's not what I said at all. You didn't break the plate, and you didn't break the plate. No. It was these space aliens. They came down and they grabbed these cows and they switched brains with the cows. And the cows with the brains of the space aliens broke the plate.
Funny, I just saw that same thing happen in a movie, Invasion of the Cow Snatchers.
You did?
That's another lie! Nothing but a big...
Huh? Fib?
Hi, Junior.
What are you doing?
Don't worry, Junior. A little Fib couldn't hurt anybody, right? That's the thing about Fibs, Junior. We grow. Now that I'm big, it's my turn to call the shots. And you belong to me.
Not so fast, monster.
Huh?
If anyone can stop that Fib, Larry Boy can. Drop the asparagus!
Why don't you come and make me, little purple man?
If that's the way it's gonna be!
Laddie, what's happening?
The monster is headed toward the Bumblyburg Water Tower. He is carrying a small asparagus. Alfred, we must find a way to stop this beast!
Yes, I'll get the computer working on it right away. Can you get to the water tower?
The road is blocked. I'm afraid I'll have to go on foot.
Well, I've made a few modifications to the Laddiemobile that might just do the trick.
You have?
Well, you know, I like to tinker in my spare time.
Is that what all these new buttons are for?
That's right. Unfortunately, I haven't had time to label them.
Oh, dear.
But if you do exactly what I say, everything should work out fine. I think.
Let's see if your little purple friend can help you up here.
What's he doing? I don't know. Maybe he fell asleep.
Well, somebody should go wake him up. So this is what you do in your spare time?
Well, not all of it. I also dabble in biochemistry, nuclear medicine, you know, this and that.
So how do we stop this thing?
Oh, yes, that. Let's see here. Ah, we know what the monster is now.
What is it?
It's a lie.
What's a lie?
It is.
Which part?
The whole thing. It's a lie. The monster is a lie.
Oh, my. Well, how do I stop it?
I'm afraid we don't know that yet. Oh, I don't think you should look, man. It's not a pretty sight.
Mom! Dad! Help!
Alfred, what kind of weapon systems do we have?
Oh, I've thought of all sorts of wonderful little ideas. doing?
What I should have done all along! Super Suctioneer, away! Alfred!
Yes, Laddie! How is it going?
I think now would be a good time for you to tell me how I can stop the fly.
Yes, yes, yes. Here comes the answer now. According to my calculations, you can do...
nothing!
Nothing?
Yes, nothing.
Why didn't you tell me that before I jumped on his head?
Well, my calculations were not yet finished.
Even a little lie can get really big, really fast. And a big lie can just swallow you up. And Junior, you made a really big lie!
Laddie boy, can you hear me? I made a discovery!
What?
You cannot stop the lie!
Alfred, we've been over this.
No, listen! You cannot stop the lie, but someone else can!
What?
I don't know yet. The computer's working on it right now.
Now, which one of you guys should I eat first?
Alfred, we have no time!
It's thinking!
You sort of look like candy.
No, really, it's spandex. It's quite bitter. Alfred!
I'm getting a reading!
Alfred!
It looks like...
Problem I know I can handle.
Dad, I'm really sorry about your plate.
Oh, Junior, I'm sure it was an accident. I just wish you would have told me right away.
I thought you'd be really mad at me.
Junior, you're much more important to me than any old bowling plate.
I guess I should be punished, huh?
I think what you've been through today was punishment enough. What do you think, Dad?
I think you're right. Let's just make sure that from now on we get the true story the first time.
Oh, doesn't it just warm your heart? And it's all because of one man, one plunger-headed hero always ready when Bumbleyburg needs him. Larry boy? Up, there he goes again.
Wow, that was really something. You did a great job, Larry. Boy.
Thank you, Bob. We need to hurry this along. I have a meeting with the action figure people in 10 minutes.
Action figures?
Yes, Bob. Larry Boy Mania is sweeping the nation. If you're not on board, you're gonna miss the train.
I had no idea.
Now you do.
Yes. Well, Junior thought the best way to get out of trouble was by telling a lie.
Yep. But to cover up for the first lie, he had to tell more and more lies until finally he was trapped. A slave to his lies.
That's right. He thought a lie would set him free. But in the end, the only way for him to get free was by telling the truth. I'm not saying that you won't get punished for what you did, but as Junior learned, facing your parents can be a lot less painful than getting stuck in a big lie.
Oh, is that right? Well, we gotta clear the stage now, Bob. It's time for the world premiere of my new music video.
You're what? You're joking, right? He's not joking. Larry, we gotta talk!
Enjoyed this episode of VeggieTales and that you learned a lot from the story. Don't forget to check out VeggieTales.com where you'll find loads of fun games, puzzles, videos, and so much more. So for me, Larry the Cucumber, and all your veggie friends, thanks for joining us and we'll see you again soon. Stay tuned for some really silly songs that'll have everyone singing along. Goodbye!
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Laddie, the part of the show where Laddie comes out and sings a silly song. One day, while talking with Dr. Archibald, Laddie confronts one of his deepest fears.
If my lips ever left my mouth, packed a bag and headed south, that'd be too bad. I'd be so sad.
I see, that'd be too bad. You'd be so sad.
That'd be too bad.
Alrighty.
If my lips said adios, I don't like you, I think you're gross, that'd be too bad. I might get mad.
That'd be too bad, you might get mad.
That'd be too bad.
Fascinating.
If my lips moved to Duluth, left a mess and took my tooth, that'd be too bad. I'd call my dad.
Oh dear, that'd be too bad, you'd call your dad.
That'd be too bad.
Hold it! Did you say your father? Fascinating! So what you're saying is, if your lips left you...
That'd be too bad, I'd be so sad, I might get mad, I'd call my dad, that'd be too bad.
That'd be too bad.
That'd be too bad.
Why?
'Cause I love my lips. Beedle-dee-bap-bop-beedle-bop-boo, ee-ba-da-bop-boo-ba-da-boo-bow. Yabba-dab-bop-dee-ba-bop-boom-bom-beedle-bop-bop-dow. Yabba-dab-a-dab-boom-bom.
Oh my, this is more serious than I thought. Laddie, what do you see here?
That looks like a lip.
What about this?
It's a lip.
And this?
It's a lip, it's a lip, it's a lip, 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 it's a lip, it's a lip, it's a lip, 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 it's a lip, it's a lip, it's a lip, 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 lip.
Laddie, tell me about your childhood.
When I was just 2 years old, I left my lips out in the cold and they turned blue. What could I do?
Oh dear, they turned blue. What could you do?
Oh, they turned blue.
I see.
On the day I got my tooth, I had to kiss my great Aunt Ruth. She had a beard, and it felt weird.
My, my, she had a beard, and it felt weird?
She had a beard.
Oh.
10 days after I turned 8, got my lips stuck in a gate. My friends all laughed. And I just stood there until the fire department came and broke the lock with the crowbar, and I had to spend the next 6 weeks in lip rehab with this kid named Oscar who got stung by a bee right on the lip, and we couldn't even talk to each other until the 5th week because both of our lips were so swollen, and when he did start speaking, he just spoke Polish, and I only knew like 3 words in Polish, except now I know 4 because Oscar taught me the word for lip. Usta.
Your friends all laughed. Usta. How do you spell that?
I don't know.
So what you're saying is that when you were young...
They turned blue, what could I do? She had a beard and it felt weird. My friends all laughed. Whoop-da!
I'm confused.
I love my lips!
This has been Silly Songs with Laddie. Tune in next time to hear Laddie say...
Have I ever told you how I feel about my nose?
Look at the time!
Bye, babu, babili, babidi, babidi, babu. car?
I like yours too.
Is it a Jeep?
A Subaru.
I like your tires.
You've got nice chrome.
A trailer hitch.
Left mine at home.
Oh, your suspension, it suspends me over heights I've never known.
And your roll bar is to die for, by the way. I like your chrome.
You already said that.
Did I?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, you and me in our sport utility vehicles, cruising to 7-Eleven for a bag of Frito-Lays. Oh, you and me in our sport utility vehicles, we'll slam into four-wheel drive and pick up a dozen eggs. And if there ever was a snow, you know,
a really, really deep snow,
and if everyone was stuck but us,
we'd be the ones not stuck.
Then we could be the heroes.
Oh, we could be the heroes.
Yeah, we would be the heroes. Who would push them and pull them?
Push them and pull them.
Push them and pull them right out of the snow.
I like your car.
I like yours too.
Periwinkle.
It's baby blue.
How's it handle?
Like a dream.
How about coffee?
And then ice cream. Oh, you and me in our sport utility vehicles, cruising to Dunkin' Donuts for a cup of steaming Joe. Oh, you and me in our sport utility vehicles, we'll slam into four-wheel drive for a scoop of Rocky Road.
And if we ever go camping, you know,
haven't been but one day, I'll go.
And we find a ranger stuck in a ditch,
a nice ranger in a deep ditch.
Then we could be the heroes.
Oh, we could be the heroes. Yeah, we would be. Is it a Jeep? It's my sport utility vehicle.
Today, Larry and Bob are on a photo safari, hot on the trail of a monkey. Or an ape. We don't know which, hence the song.
If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. Even if it has a monkey kind of shape. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey.
Let's see if we can catch it on the tape.
You can very plainly see if it's a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape.
Look, there it goes, there it goes. I don't know, I can't tell if it's a monkey or an ape.
It's very simple, Bob. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape.
Larry, I'm not so sure.
Ooga booga, isn't that a monkey?
Ooga booga, maybe it's an ape.
If it's a nickel or a salad or a pillow, if it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape.
If it doesn't have a tail...
Not a monkey.
Are you sure that's what you really mean to say? A camera has no tail.
It's not a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape.
I think there's something wrong with your logic, Larry.
Well, Bob, the lady at the zoo said it. And who am I to tell her that she's wrong? If there's a tail, it's a monkey. No tail, ape. It's easy.
But Larry, a kite has a tail.
Then it's a monkey.
A comet has a tail.
It's a monkey.
A bubble doesn't.
Then it's not a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey.
It's an ape?
Exactly. I knew you'd catch on.
Larry, we might need to talk about this. I don't think the lady at the zoo meant...
Shh. Look, there it goes in the trees. Follow me. It's gotta be a monkey or an ape. I can't believe it's true. All this time I've searched for you. Snap the picture, take the shot. We're among the lucky few. We finally did it, photographer. We've discovered what we're after. Let me look. Is it an ape?
Larry, this is a disaster.
It's a monkey.
Larry, that's a cow, not
that
a...
That was exhilarating. Let's find more! If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. Even if it has a monkey kind of shape. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey. If it doesn't have a tail, it's not a monkey, it's an ape.
This has been Silly Songs with Larry. Tune in next time to hear Bob say...
Larry, you don't have a tail.
I don't?
Nope, and neither do I.
I wouldn't be so sure about that, Bob.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing.